Hi everyone, hope you're doing well. Recently I visited my native Udupi and I made few village style outdoor cooking videos. In today's video, I'll be showing a sweet rice dumpling recipe cooked in jackfruit leaf called Chilmidadde. It's made during special occasions. The entire process was prepared by my aunts and my mom. I'll show you how it's made. Add 2 cups of parboiled rice in a bowl. Wash the rice till the water runs clear. Drain the water. Then soak it for at least 4 to 5 hours or overnight. Discard the water and add the soaked rice in wet grinder. Add 1/4 cup of water. Switch on the grinder. Add a teaspoon of rock salt and grind to a thick, smooth and soft dough. Keep it aside. Now to prepare the filling, we'll need an entire coconut. Scrape the coconut. Add 1 cup of soft jaggery, 1/2 teaspoon of cardamom powder. Give it a good mix until nicely combined. Finally add some cow ghee. Mix it again and set it aside. To prepare the mold, we'll need some fresh jackfruit leaves. And to seal the mold, we'll need broomsticks from coconut leaves. Wash them thoroughly in water and drain. Chop the sticks in 2-inch pieces. Pat dry the leaves with a clean cotton cloth. To make the mold, hold a leaf horizontally, fold both ends to form a cone. Secure the edge with a broomstick. This is how it should look. Repeat till all the leaves are shaped. Take a lime-sized ball of the prepared rice dough. Gently line the insides of the leaf cone to form a thin, even layer. Remove any excess dough. Stuff with the prepared coconut and jaggery filling. Cover with a small portion of dough. Make sure it's nicely sealed. Repeat until all the dough and filling have been used up. This is the outdoor fireplace. We call it Dikkil in Tulu language. Bring some water to a rolling boil in an idli steamer. Place the prepared cones into the slotted plate. Cover and steam for 30 minutes. It has got this beautiful aroma from the leaves. Remove gently on a plate. Let them cool for a bit before enjoying them. Unmold the adda. Cut in half. Pour some cow ghee before serving. If you have seen my coriander neer dosa and masala neer dosa videos, the credit for that recipes goes to her. Please don't forget to give this video a like, follow, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I'll see you in my next video.